We are at 14261 Cleveland Avenue in Fort Myers, and it's Kitchen Social. See right there? Right there. Kitchen Social. Kitchen Social. So this place is amazing. Now, I've been drinking for the last 2 hours and making food, and I forgot to do the intro. So I figure I better do the intro before we actually leave, right? This place is, you book it to cook anything you want. It's like a cooking, eating event. And I brought my whole family. It's absolutely amazing. We made filet mignon, lobster wrapped, or lobster stuffed ravioli, and roasted balsamic vegetables and creme brulee. And it was so good. It takes about 2 to 3 hours. It's the middle of a Saturday. So I'm gonna go home and go to bed. I mean, I've literally been drinking and cooking and prepping and cooking and eating for the last 3 hours, but it was so much fun. I'm trying to get their name in the frame. I'll put the link down below. You've got to try this. It's amazing. They have two units. One in Minneapolis, I think he said. One here in Fort Myers. I brought my whole family and a private event, and it was a blast. I would highly recommend it. Stay tuned. I'll show you through how we made pasta, how we made the filet mignon, how we made creme brulee. They start with that. They start with the creme brulee, and that way it's, you know, chilled. Then we did the vegetables. Then we did the ravioli, then we did the filet. It was amazing. It was so much fun. You bring your own wine, you bring your own beer, and I would recommend it to anyone that is looking for a really unique thing to do with your family and friends. So stay tuned.
Digging the playlist.
Thanks, I put on Soul Funky Classics.
Oh.
Soul Funky, write that down.
How much?
Right?
So I can say.
Flatten it down. This is just forming it into a shaggy ball for us to knead. Sticking. So what you're gonna do now, we all have some stuff on our hands. We're going to rub our hands together to create friction, and all those dough balls can just come right off. I'm gonna push down towards you. You're gonna push down towards me. Push down and out. Fold it over onto itself. Turn it 90 degrees. Push down and out. You continue to do this. You are creating elasticity in the dough. You're exciting the gluteins, and you're creating protein strands.
Exciting the gluteins.
Yes.
There's just something about that I like.
Yeah.
Glutes are excited.
Glutes are excited.
Sharp.
Put them both. And you're just going to make this flat. There are some chefs that will only flatten one corner of the pasta and send this whole thing through. All that does is cause extra work for you. So make the whole thing just a little bit flatter so it's easier to go through our pasta machines. Back. You can rub it in a little bit if you want to.
I know, and I'm using it. I'm using it.
You know.
Would you like to help,
Dylan? Just get a puff pastry and it's
I'm watching. I help a little bit.
Yeah.
If you need to unscrew it a little bit, screw it down so it actually sticks onto the countertop, you can. And then you're just going to hook it onto the counter.
I should do this.
Yes,
I actually did this.
We should do this.
Bullshit.
No, you're doing
it. I don't want to. What if it moves?
And then tighten it. You just did it over here. My side is cubic. Once it comes out, you're gonna fold it in half and send it through again. This creates a layer, and the more layers you have, the less likely it is to rip and tear. You fold it.
Yeah, fold it.
So fold it in half and send it through again. I only do one fold here in class.
You getting this?
At home, you could do up to 100. I just do one. And do that with all of your pasta.
Up to 100 passes?
You could.
You don't need
it. If you're having trouble, you can always tighten your machine to your countertop.
Oh, right out of there into the fridge.
My fridge is used to the damage.
Okay.
That does it. But since I only have cheese and my prep.
Okay,
beer,
no more beer for Kyle for a little while.
If you place it in
Tupperware, your Pyrex Tupperware? No, that stuff is fine.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, if you, this would crack.
So that's mozzarella. We have crumbled lobster.
Eat it.
Then you have ricotta.
Oh, I love ricotta.
Me too.
As much as you love soup.
I know, I could just parmesan. I could put ricotta on soup.
You too.
Look at that creaminess.
And then some garlic.
Oh, garlic. Oh, yeah.
The lemon is going to be for after our ravioli is done to squeeze over some fresh lemon.
Literally put lemon on everything.
And with your lobster, in whatever order you want, and you're gonna mix it all together.
The ricotta?
No, all three cheeses. Ricotta's a cheese. And a parm.
That looks like you did something.
Appreciate that.
And
then she'll
put it on like a
crispy
30
minutes
meat.
Later,
my tummy hurts.
You put everything in there?
She said put everything in there. Yep, yep. And then mix it
down. I even watched her do it to make sure I was hearing it right.
It's okay.
Oh, she said put everything except the water?
She didn't. No, she said all your cheese is in garlic.
Watch the video later and then you'll know.
You guys can taste this mixture. The lobster is already cooked. And then, you can adjust your seasonings with salt and pepper already.
What's that?
You can taste it.
There you go.
Do you want to stir?
No.
Apparently you don't think I'm doing a good enough job.
I think you're doing a great job.
Mm-hmm. I'd like a bigger bowl, please.
Mix it on the table.
I thought about it.
Salt and pepper. I'm a pepperaholic, so
you'd be generous.
There's probably a benefit to keeping it more compact.
I don't really like this.
Either.
Whoa!
I like pepper.
See, if we had a
what's wrong with lots of pepper?
If we had a pepper cannon, you wouldn't need to do that many cranks.
Any turns?
Only three turns, right? Put some salt in there. There's no salt in anything.
It's good. We don't need salt.
There's no salt in anything.
Yes, there is. There's salt in all of the cheese.
Oh, really? Yeah.
Go ham, Kyle.
You can add that to your list of.
Did you?
Yep.
Shut up.
So what you're gonna do is you're gonna dollop your mixture as much or as little as you would like, but all you're gonna use all of this mixture for all four of your raviolis, for all four of your pasta sheets. And you only wanna place it about a half of an inch away from themselves.
A crab doobie.
Don't ask him. All right. I have various sizes, so you guys don't feel like you need to
do it now.
Oh
no, we're still watching.
No gaps in between.
Grab your water.
You got a rolling machine for that crab doobie?
Pay attention.
And you wet the edge.
I know, and do that.
And you're going to wet in between each one.
To make it stick.
Wet in between.
Yes.
Stop it.
Wow. It'll be moist.
Sounds dirty.
And then what you're going to do is you're going to flip it over.
Oh, see, mine's like not very light.
That's okay. Just you're going to add it like right here and you'll be able to flip.
On the end? Okay. Mm-hmm.
You're going to have little baby raviolis.
To make it closer to one edge than the other.
And so then.
And then do we take that fun tool that cuts them and makes them like all squiggly?
Yep.
Oh, look, you see
and
that?
You're going
she did
to
the
choppy
thing.
You guys. Squeeze the edges and in between.
Hey, she didn't give the all clear to start.
And if you have an end right here, you just can use your fingers to kind of pinch it together.
You have to put it closer to the bottom so when
you
fold it. You
guys can start.
Look at this.
You don't want it in the middle.
Look what I'm doing. Look at this. Look at how that looks. Crazy.
Am I too far to one side or am I okay?
That's okay.
Right there.
Can you move it?
Where are you being so mean?
Awesome.
You're being mean.
I'm being mean.
Stop being mean, Dylan. Oh my goodness.
Should I put them all on there first?
Yeah. Oh, that's enough. You gotta, you see what she did, the choppy thing? You gotta put your hands in between.
I know, but I'm gonna do all of them first and then fold them all over.
Oh yeah, I guess that is the program.
You can help.
This one's gonna be hard.
Yeah.
You also have an extra one at your station. My oven's just having a ball right now. You guys hear it turning on?
Yeah,
what
are
you doing? Hey,
do you
want
to do this one? You're gonna get crazy.
No, you got it.
Get
your
in my way.
And you just
you're doing the
them onto
the water moist, right, making it moist.
Do the water. Right.
Yeah, you gotta do the wheelie thing.
This is so
funny. And I guess you could cut the ends off, but she said save the ends and we'll cook them and they'll be like extra pasta.
Yours look pretty good.
I know, that's because I'm exceptional at this.
That's because she helped him.
I split mine.
Oh.
That crab coming out.
That's okay, just squeeze it back together.
You gotta fix that, don't you? Because won't the innards come out in the water?
Okay, I got a band-aid.
Who?
He squished it. His is popping out.
Perfect now.
Okay, can you get it out of my face?
As long as you're happy with your circuit.
You guys are annoying. Just saying.
Look, I don't want your ravioli inside contaminating my
it won't be.
Perfect raviolis.
He's pretty.
Oh, you do have your own pot?
Yes.
You can do whatever you want then.
You don't have to remember which ones are yours.
I know, Jesus.
Dad's like, let me study these real quick.
I know. He's worrying about his vegetables and...
Can we stamp, like... We need a secret stamp.
Dude, this one is gorgeous. Look how pretty.
Wow. That
is impressive. I'm just taking credit for it.
Who made it? Kyle made it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Kyle with his...
No, that's my double.
ADD. Made the perfect ravioli.
But then he made this.
Oh, come on.
Then he made some that aren't quite cute.
And I don't know what this is.
I want the extra noodle.
No, not unless you want to.
No need to fight over it. It's okay. Let's
eat. Where are all your little bits?
They're gone.
What? Hey, we want to save our little bits.
You're supposed to help.
We want to save that. You didn't save your little bits either?
Dylan swaggerjacked them.
Dylan did what?
He swaggerjacked them.
Bobby, you were supposed to
cure
the ravioli over here. You guys can
do it again.
Request, be like, hey, I'm requesting to sit in the middle of the countertop. You can do that.
You can do that.
Yes. Like if other people are going to be here. Yes.
So if you come to a public, you can request a certain spot.
Yes. That's cool.
All right.
All right. Really nice.
Did you wash your hands?
The thing is this seed is probably
worth it. Okay. Yeah, I've never made a heavy cream sauce like this.
Garlic. You notice
there's no flour to make a brew. Oh, yeah,
there's not. There's no
one. How come?
Flour to make a brew, and it's because traditional cream sauces is just cream, cheese, and the starch from the pasta mixed together to create that creamy consistency.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
There's always room for garlic.
Ah.
Oh shit!
It's like your
we're all going home together.
So it's a garlic sauce with white wine and cheese and cream.
Every steak, and you got one at a time.
Nothing
very helpful. Now fresh pasta.
I'm videotaping.
These strands right here.
What do you want me to do? Hey. Drop a few in.
Yeah.
They're done. So if you're making fettuccine or angel hair at home, once they float, they're done. But ravioli, once they're floating, you want them to float for 45 seconds because they're sandwiched between and there's a thicker layer of pasta.
What do we do with the scraps?
Throw them in. Yeah.
Throw them in. She said when they float, they're done.
We throw the scraps in at the
end.
I threw my scraps in.
Oh, she already said that?
45 more seconds.
Come on, you know my program.
You guys can grab any utensil to stir that around.
What
he just grabbed is called a spider. You don't have to take I'm gonna be straining them.
Oh, so okay.
These guys. But once you guys are at that floating point, you're going to time it in your head on your phone out loud 45 seconds, and then you're gonna turn the induction unit off.
You're gonna regret not having scraps.
But they're all should be floating.
Just saying.
So we have one scrap.
I'm on a diet.
Yeah. So now that I have a couple floating, I'm gonna start mine.
Why didn't you put those in?
Oh, you did. They're just floating.
I did. They started floating.
So he pulled them out.
Eat one.
Ow, I'm trying to. They're hot. It's fucking slimy.
Is it good? Not good.
Pretty good.
Pretty good.
Is box ruined forever?
Probably.
Mmm.
Getting that workout.
Elbow. And the burner doesn't have to be on?
Nope.
She said that, you need to listen.
When I'm at home, I straight up put my pasta in a bowl, like a silver bowl, and I do this. then I create my cream sauce. And you'll notice after about between two and five minutes, it does thicken up. In Italy, it is one person's job in the restaurant to solely mix together cream, cheese with fresh pasta for 5 minutes tossing before they send it out.
Wow. His name is the saucer.
The saucer. The pasta maker.
The saucier.
The saucier.
Oh, we have to wrap around our own figs?
Yeah.
What the hell do you think this is?
I tried to wrap my own jalapeno poppers one day and it didn't work. It's time for the meat. Which one I'll grab it? This one.
I mean, peppers?
No, you can do it, but this needs salt. You need to salt it and not get over your
pepper.
Lack of salt thing.
It's so much salt. I'm sorry. More?
A little bit.
It's just a lot of salt.
Yep. Okay. How much salt I put on the steak you ate the other night?
I know, and I can't use my hands.
You gotta flip it over and salt the other side.
I thought she said don't.
If you want the best for your body.
Okay.
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 Okay. Okay. Okay. And then I gave you this little toothpick. You're gonna stab where that bacon ends to hold it together.
Okay. You're gonna do your turn.
I got a good piece of meat.
No, you do it.
I don't know what you're talking about, Kyle.
Yeah. You tell.
Is that good?
That is perfect.
Okay. You know what I want you guys to see if you can, but if you don't have to. This is a Bulgur brand pan. And it's got a high cast iron wall on the bottom. And what that does is it turns your induction unit on. Your induction unit has a magnet underneath the glass top, and anything that is induction compatible, either a magnet will stick to or it's cast iron. Now once you start going up in temperature, there's little ions between the glass top and the magnet, and they begin to vibrate, almost like a salt. Huh. I had one of these in college. Did the whole thing heat up for you, or just?
No, I had like a flat dish with a pan thing. It looked like a really flat pan that I put on it, and then any pan.
Your oil is ready, but if it takes like 3 to 5 seconds for those bubbles to form, it's not ready.
Okay.
Good. So go ahead and grab yourself a pair of tongs. Tong. You're gonna place your meat seasoned side down, and then season the bottom side in the pan. Every single thing that we take into our body besides water has a glucose level, has a blood sugar intake. And when we apply that to heat, the first layer of the cellular wall will dissipate, the sugars are released, and they begin to caramelize. And it's not what you think of when I say caramel, that buttery, smooth, candy caramel. But it is caramelized glucose.
I didn't wrap this a little bit, look, it's coming off.
All right, flip it.
It's sticking.
Yeah.
It's sticking. I'm not ready yet. It's
been a while. Yeah, that's good. It's got color.
Good, Daddy. Okay, it didn't fall off.
You
need
a toothpick
it better.
Yeah, you need a toothpick it better.
Two stories.
Too nice to it.
I know.
It's gonna be super rare. That's super rare. Okay. Gotta wipe all that. What's up with
and
that?
And then I would sit my steak on top of it so it doesn't look like retirement food. Nice height to it. Nice color on the bottom. I would grab a silver spoon and I would take some of my raviolis.
Silver spoon here.
Did you find the silver spoon? It might be in both of your mouths. Did you get that?
I got it, but I'm not mad about it. And that's how I would play coin.
Very nice.
I'm gonna come and get rid of.
Wow, well done.
We have a lot of ravioli left.
I know.
We made a lot of ravioli. We didn't make big ones. We made tiny little ones.
You guys have good leftovers?
And now he's on like a 3-month leave. And then he finds another.
What?
Good leftovers?
Yeah, we do.
Even when I make something like meatballs, and it's really tiny, so I get more.
Nice.
I know, it took my brain.
Lots of ravioli.
Exactly. And little ones.
Like,
try to do a thin, even layer,
because
that's what gets the brulee.
Yes, brulee needs to burn. This is simple. You're just going to push this, and it turns on.
Oh, yeah.
So then you go over it, and you can be close, or you can be far. It's all your comfort standpoint. And it starts to melt the sugar, and you'll start to develop color, like how you see right there. It starts to smell like burnt sugar. That's what you want. Can you go as dark as you want?
Oh, it smells so good. You gotta get like a whole coat over the whole thing though. Shake it a little bit like this.
A whole coat.
I was like, shake it a little bit.
You'll be in a coma later.
Oh, I see. Oh, that looks so good.
Okay, you're good.
There we go.
Yeah, you're gonna take like 45 minutes to burn that.
Well, what happens if you add a lot is the top will roulette, but then the bottom ones have pretty sugar.
That is so cool. This is science in the making.
Where's your goggles?
Oh, it smells so good.
I think you put a little bit too much sugar.
We did have
it. We just want an extra. Oh, look at how it's all crispling up like that. Oh, that looks good.
Yeah.
Cool. Nice, who doesn't?
If you hold it a little further to let it crush, really get liquidy.
Yeah.
Then you can come in closer.
Oh, it smells so good.
Off.
Look at you. Mom's gonna come around with new napkins and she's...
Wow.
Yeah, bubble. I solder every now and then.
Oh, that's true. You cheat.
Yeah,
you're a cheater.
Just like sugar, copper. Same thing.
All right.
Today, calories don't count.
Yeah, that's true.
Oh, it already smells like vanilla. That vanilla, and then when you taste it, you get that little bit of lemon from that zest. Great.
Is there always lemon?
No, that's my little twitch to it.
I like it.
I've never made one before, but I didn't know that.
Usually it's just vanilla. But you could also make chocolate creme brulee by adding cocoa powder. You could add strawberry puree, make strawberry creme brulee. So good. So good. Around the holiday season, we have a maple.
Is that brulee. Wild how fast it melts?
Yeah. Maple
in brightness. Yes. You know that's funny because in my fall.
Well, if you've been with me this long, you're either an amazing subscriber or you're just really interested in actually doing this. Both are really good. You can see this was a private event, just my family. You get to go up there and participate. You can see on the monitors. The place is top notch. As I was editing, it occurred to me that I didn't really show you anything we did with the vegetables. We just dumped them out on a tray, covered them in seasoning, balsamic vinegar, some oil, and some Parmesan cheese, and then baked them. This was the second thing we did. The first thing we did was the creme brulee, and then the second thing we did was the vegetables and got them in the oven, and they were baking while we were doing the other things. Here's the pasta making tools, which we are for sure going to invest in to make pasta at home. Super cool and so much easier than I thought. Also, once we started eating, I just completely forgot about filming, and this was the final result. You've got the filet mignon on top of the vegetables, and then all of that amazing ravioli that we made. So thanks so much for watching. Please subscribe. This video is not monetized because of all of the background music. So yeah, pretty much the main motivation here is subscribers and of course sharing this amazing experience at Kitchen Social. As always, thanks so much and see you next time.